Hello and welcome to the Performance Centre here at Howley Hall Golf Club in Leeds, where today I'm taking a look at the brand new G425 irons from Ping. Hi there, Ryan Rastall here for golfshake.com. I'm PGA professional down here at Howley Hall Golf Club in Leeds, and as I've said, today we're taking a look at the brand new G425 irons from Ping. But before we do that, please make sure you hit that subscribe button, see loads more content from all of us here at Golf Shake to help you play more and play better. So I've had a lot of people asking me when we're going to do a review on G425, and it is finally here. So the samples came a couple of days ago, and I've had a bit of a chance to hit them so far here in the Performance Center, but not a hell of a lot. So I'm really looking forward to doing that later. Now, whenever an iron comes out from Ping, people are always interested. People want to try it. There's a lot of diehard Ping fans out there that are desperate to get the latest iron from their favorite brand. And these have obviously replaced the very popular G410 line of irons. And whenever a new G iron comes out from Ping, there's a massive buzz about it. And we're going to talk you through the key technologies in here now. So what Ping have actually done with this iron is introduced a bit more tungsten into the toe and the heel to help make the iron slightly more forgiving. Now, for the first time as well, they've used variable face thickness in the design of it to get faster ball speeds across the face. And Ping are saying this is the fastest G iron they've ever produced, which, let me tell you, is some claim. Now, the G iron series has been so popular, and there's loads of people out there that will have G series irons. And to know that this one is the fastest that's ever come out is definitely gonna make your ears prick up and want you to go and try this. So obviously we're gonna put it through its paces and have a bit of a look in a second, but yeah, we'll tell you exactly what we think. Now, we've got this pearlized finish as well, which I think looks absolutely lovely. When you sit these clubs down in the playing position, this was the first thing I noticed. They just look so much nicer, I think. They're a bit more sleeker, a bit more streamlined, the design, and Ping have put this new multi-material cartridge in the back of the head as well, which they're saying is going to improve the feel. So all of this stuff sounds good. It's going to be faster off the face, it looks nicer, and it's going to feel better. Who doesn't want that? The great addition as well this year is that every Ping golf club has the Arcos Caddy Smart Grip included in it. Now, for those of you that don't know anything about this, basically it links with an app that you can get and will tell you how far you hit every single golf club that you've got one of these chips in. So it really allows you to map out all your distances within your game, and also have a bit of a look post-round at where your strengths and weaknesses are, what bits you need to improve on, whether there's a club missing in your set that you might need to bridge a gap, all those sorts of things. The data that you get from Arcos is outstanding, and I recommend anyone try it because it's such a great addition. And to get it as standard built in these clubs is brilliant. Now, I can't wait to hit these. I'm going to hit them against the club that they're replacing as well to see exactly how they perform. The great thing about when we get clubs from Ping to test is that they're always built to our spec. So I went to Ping a while back and got fitted for my for a full set. So they've got all my specs on record, and every time they send me something to test, it always comes in that spec, which is absolutely fantastic. It saves me having to mess about too much when we get the clubs here as well. So let's stop talking. Let's go hit some shots and see exactly how these new irons perform. So I'm gonna start off with pitching wedge, okay? So we've got a half set here. We've got wedge, 8, 6, and 4 iron to try. So let's have a bit of a go with pitching wedge, see how we get on. Actually really like the look of it behind the ball. It doesn't look like a kind of mid-handicapper's golf club, really. I think it sits really nicely behind it. And yes, so you can tell it's a Ping straight away, definitely, but that's not a bad thing. I always like that white kind of bottom groove paint fill that Ping have. I think it just really helps when you're aligning yourself to target. And these feel really, really good. Like I say, I think they sit absolutely great. It's obviously a help when you're testing it, when it's got the shaft that you use in it, the grip thickness, the length, all those sorts of things. So just to let you know, mine are 1/2 inch longer and blue color code is what I always use. So, which is 1 degree upright. I
Very good. Feels great. Interested in if this feel continues all the way through the set. Certainly it feels different because of this kind of dampening effect that they've got on the back of the head there, so that's good. Moved on to 6-iron now, and certainly looking at this, really notice that little bit more offset on there, and also it starts to look a little bit chunkier as well. So let's give it a hit and see. They are starting to look quite strong loft-wise now. It's a 6-iron, but like I say, sitting it down, it looks more like a 5 when you sit it behind the ball, which, you know, to be fair, it is. But yeah, and certainly when we're looking distance already, I've just hit 2. The first one was a horrible strike, and it's gone 190. Second one, a bit better, 200 yards with a 6-iron, which is longer than I would normally hit it, definitely. Again, decent strike. It's very high flight now though, 195. Again, it's probably a club longer really than what I would imagine from the same number in my own set. But feels good, feels still decent, yeah. Again, a bit out the bottom of the club again. Still got 185 out of it, which is what I would normally hit a 6-iron generally. So the forgiveness aspect's there. Let's just hit one more, then we'll move on to the 4-iron. Much better strike, again up at 193 again, so the distance is very, very good.
Let's have a bit of a look then at how these irons have performed. So we'll start with pitching wedge. So we're getting 137, 138 yards total. 8-iron, 172, which is long for an 8-iron really. 6-iron, 200 yards as an average, which again is longer than I would normally hit. But the 4-iron, wow, 244 for a 4-iron. I mean, that is just immense. When I was hitting it, it felt like a 3-wood when I was hitting it. It was coming off so fast. So we can see that face technology, I think, particularly in those clubs, in the 4 and 6 iron, it's just coming off so fast. And certainly Ping are saying it's almost like metal wood, like in the way that it performs. And we can see that that's absolutely the case. And when you look on there as well, I've actually put the I had a G4 10 iron here, which was a 7 iron to compare it to. So the 8 iron in G4 25 is 34.5 degrees, okay, which in most people's opinion is a 7 iron anyway, and certainly it is mine. My 7 iron at the moment is 36 degrees actually, so it's even weaker than that. But certainly when we look at that on here, we can see that the sort of ball speed we're getting with G425 is comparable to what we're seeing in the 7 iron in G410. So it's coming off exactly the same, even to the 0.7 of a mile an hour there. We can see it's coming off at exactly the same speed. So there is quite a difference in the loft here as well. So it's about 4 or 5 degrees between the two. And we're seeing the same ball speed, which is crazy. Yeah, the G410 7 iron is going a little bit further, but we'd expect it to just because of the loft, really. But we're swinging it. I've actually swung the G425 slightly faster, but the ball speed's coming off exactly the same, ever so slightly shorter in terms of carry and total distance. But it's about half a club, really. So what Ping are saying about this being the fastest G series iron kind of is backed up by the numbers that we're seeing here, and this iron is very, very long. Normally when I fitted Ping irons in the past, I haven't found distance wise that they've been, you know, sort of jumping off the screen and sort of making people buy them for distance. It's always been about the quality of how they're built and also the design and the kind of forgiveness that you get with Ping. But this iron is kind of bucking that trend a little bit. It's showing that these are very, very long. And particularly, I mean, well, look at that four iron. That is just crazy. I've never hit a four iron that long in my life, no matter what four iron I've tried, whether it be a driving iron type golf club or even a hybrid or anything like that. I don't think I've got anything over the sort of 240 to 245 mark with a four iron, which is crazy. I mean, you know, that being said, when we look at the loft of the four iron in this set, it is strong, you know. If we look at it on here, so it is 20.5 degrees, so that is it's stronger than a three iron. Generally three iron in my head is always 21. I know most out there are stronger than that now, but yeah, it's ever so slightly stronger than a three iron. But even that said, I've never hit a three iron that long either. So it is seriously, seriously good golf club and very quick off the face, and it's certainly one that is definitely worth trying, even if you've got last year's model or maybe a couple of G irons back. I think what you're going to find is there's a progression here where it looks a little bit nicer, but also we can see the performance is better as well. The distance is good, the feel was good with that new cartridge in the back of the head really dampening that feel, and certainly didn't feel like a big cavitied head iron, and it doesn't look like one either when you sit it behind the ball. It actually looks quite nice. So hope you've enjoyed the video. I've loved testing these, and I always love hitting new product, but particularly when it's Ping stuff, because everyone raves about Ping, and it's great to test it and hit it and have an opinion on it, really. So when my customers come and see me, I can tell you what I found when I hit it, and I absolutely love having that conversation with them as well. If you've got any questions about what you've seen with the G425 range or anything to do with any of the new equipment that's coming out, please don't hesitate to put something in the comments section. We will get back to you. If you want to see this compared against another iron that's out there on the market, we'll endeavor to do that for you as well. Keep watching all of our content here on the channel with all the new golf clubs coming out early this year, and hope to see you all very, very soon.